All right, there we go. Now I got some audio. All right, I got it right this time. Takes me a bit. What can I tell you? All right, this needs to be your year. This is the year you need to get certified. I'm sure everybody has heard of WikiLeaks. I'm going to talk about a couple of different topics, but there's something called IT leaks as well, just so you know. If you didn't know, I'm going to tell you right now. There's something called IT leaks. There's people out there that think they know what the hell they're talking about, but they have no clue on what they're talking about, okay? So the first thing that you need to do is forget about all these negative people that say, don't get the certification. It's useless. Don't do it, because either they couldn't do it or they did it and they can't do shit with it, okay? So forget those people. That's number one, okay? Number two is, just like, you know, our parents or our relatives or, you know, everybody tells us, hey, you go to high school, get your high school diploma. Then you go to college, get your college diploma, right? Whether it be an associate's, you know, you get your bachelor's, you know, if you want to really go for the gusto, you get your master's, and then your PhD. Hey, bravo, bravo. That is awesome. But I don't think you got 10 years to waste, or, you know, hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars. Okay. I mean, if you're going to be a doctor, that's a whole nother story. If you're going to be a doctor or a lawyer, well, then, well, you got no choice. You got to go to college. You got to pass the bar. You got to all do all these things. All right. But in IT, this is geared to IT. Okay. In IT, we don't have to do that. All right. In IT, we got certifications. All right. So now there's some foundational certifications that we should have, because just you tell somebody you're in IT, you know programming, you know web design, you know security, you know everything there is to know about IT. You know, they think you know it all, and you didn't study programming, you didn't study web design, you know what I mean? But you're IT, so you're supposed to know it. All right, so you need to know where you're going. Now, foundational, you know, A+. You know, I got my A+ way back when. Got it, forgot about it. I hated repair. Okay, but that's not what I wanted to do, but I got it anyway. Okay, then I got my Network Plus. Okay, and then I got my Security. Why? It's not, that's not the order, but then I got the Security Plus. Okay, I got my Cisco. All right, I even got my Microsoft. And even later on, I upgraded to the Windows 7 because the college or the technical institution that I was at made me take the, was it Windows 7? Yeah, Windows 7 certification. So I took that. All right. But the thing is, in the world that we live in today, we need paper to pad our resumes. I said this a million freaking times. We need to pad our resumes. We do. But this is the problem. This is the problem. There's a thing, and listen, I'm the first one to admit that I used to say, you know what? The test and the real world is the same thing. No, it's not. It used to be more or less, but now I can tell you it's not. It's not. It's not. It's not. Okay, it isn't. It isn't the real world. Okay, there's a lot of gaps. There's a lot of foundational things that are missing, but these are things that we need to get anyway. Do you think that when you graduate from a mainstream university, okay, with your bachelor's in computer science or your bachelor's in networking, that you're going to get a job ASAP? Some of you might. Some of you might. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I think you can get it. I don't know. I'll see. If you can, I'll send it. If not, it's going to be on YouTube anyway. I think it's recorded. One of the things is, once you get your bachelor's, I've taught people that came out of mainstream universities with their bachelor's in programming, all right, which is their bachelor's in computer science or bachelor's in networking, because they still didn't. I would put an IP address up on the board. They wouldn't know what the hell to tell me. They didn't know that. Okay. And the reason I'm saying this is because you don't got 10 years to waste. This is the year that you need to be. Yes, it should be recorded. It should be recording. Oh, it's being recorded. Okay. This is the year that you need to get certified. Now, there's people out there, you know, because we know what Cisco did with the CCNA. The CCNA used to be several tests. Now it's one humongous test, right? Now you got 2 hours to do it. Okay. It's CCNA 200-301, but they made it more valuable. All right. Yes. Thank you, Cisco. Okay. You made it more valuable for us. All right. Because now we got security in there. We got wireless in there. We got programming in there. Some programming. It doesn't get crazy. Okay. So there's a lot of different things that are in there. They're just going to make us, as they say, more well-rounded, okay? So CCNA, for those people who say that CCNA is not an entry-level certification, they're full of shit. They don't know what the hell they're talking about, okay? CCNA is a level. It is a entry-level certification. Do they have a lot of stuff now? Yeah, well, you know what that takes? It takes for you to study. It takes for you to purchase the book. Some of you like Cisco Press, go for it. Volume 1, Volume 2, remember to register at Cisco Press, ciscopress.com/register with the ISBN. Okay, I think you have to create an account. And I, Laz, recommend Todd Lamley's book, all right? Because of Todd Lamley, I got his book so I could get my CCNA way back in the day, all right? And I've used his books since. He's great because it makes it very simple, straightforward, easy to understand. And he also has a companion website, all right, that you can go to, all right? So, but you got enough time now. And, you know, now that I got this book, I'm excited. I'm not pissed or anything like that. That's just the way I talk, okay? So don't get offended. I got this book today. So that's why I'm excited because I'm doing a boot camp on this on August 22nd, I believe it is. August 22nd to December 6th, I think, is the boot camp. It's going to be a long-ass boot camp because there's a lot of information. But the thing is that there's people out there that, you know, people are getting confused. People are getting confused. People are getting scared, okay? First of all, stop doubting yourself. Stop doubting yourself, all right? You gotta believe in yourself, and you got to say the hell with everybody else, okay? I want to improve my life. I want to improve my family's life. I don't care what you say. I care about what my needs are. And my needs is I need to get the CCNA. I need to get this Microsoft. By the way, if you didn't know, June 30th of this year, Microsoft just killed all their Microsoft certifications. If you go to their website, you're going to see a bunch of role-based. So whatever role you're going to play in the company, that's the certification you're going to get. All right? So, yeah, that's going to be – it's insane with Microsoft now. So it's evolving. It's ever-evolving. Why do you think that I named my company the Networking Doctors? Because we are doctors in a sense of IT, all right? There's no way I would cut into a human body, all right? I'm not going to be responsible for that. You can computer, you can throw it away by anyone, okay? But with IT, you're just like a doctor. It's and you never stop learning. And you have to go through the entire book. I can tell you right now, because I gave boot camps right towards the end of the year, November, December. I even did some stuff in January, 8-hour refreshers, 4-hour refreshers. And these people got certified. One of the boot camps, 4 out of the 5, got certified. One didn't get certified because of a lot of personal issues. All right. If not, that individual would have been certified as well. But the thing is, you have to go through the book. I don't care if you get me, David, Chris, Neil, whoever, okay? Whatever instructor, you know, that you get to teach you this stuff, okay? You need to make sure that you go through the book with a fine-tooth comb, okay? Honestly, believe going to CCIE is like getting... Listen, CCIE is equal to a PhD. I'm sorry, you know, unless you want to go to the pinnacle, which is the architect. But yeah, I mean, if you get to that level, that's awesome. That's awesome. But if you want, I'm saying it live, okay? If you want to get ready for your CCIE lab exam, your hands-on, which is 8 hours and $1,600, you better go to ine.com. Or they're the ones that prepare CCIEs to get that exam. And they're the only ones that I know that can prepare you to get that exam, okay? But anyway, the whole thing with IT leaks, there's somebody out there, I don't know who the hell this person is, all right? Well, that's not only one person. Various people are green and they're saying, yeah, that's true and all this. First of all, CCNA is an entry-level certification. It is. All right. It is an entry-level certification. That it's more information now. Oh, well, study. Okay. Study. But it is an entry-level certification. Because I can tell you right now, when I got this book, I was so excited. I said, let me go into the chapters in the back. Right. And then they talk about the Cisco 3-layer model and the collapse architecture as well. But they explain why the little gaps that everybody's missing. Okay, why do we do a two-layer collapse or tier two or tier three, right? And somebody's saying out there that there's that nobody uses spanning tree or you'll be executed or something like that. I'm like, what? There's spanning tree in the friggin' this for this boot camp all the way up to CCIE. There's spanning tree. And there's ways to guard against all these different, things for spanning tree to make it more efficient. Is this person talking about Trill, or they're talking about Cisco Fabric Path? Oh, okay. Or ENC, equal cost multipath routing. Well, guess where that's at, there, brother or sister? Right here in this book. Okay, not the CCNA. Okay. Not the CCNA. CCNA, you need to know foundational stuff. And one of the foundational stuff is spanning tree. You need to know about that. Do you think companies, nobody runs spanning? Who? What? No. And as far as, that's just wrong. Okay. It's funny that people say, well, I got 20 years experience. I know it all. Really? Do you? Do you now? Let me see. I did the math. I was sitting down in the bathroom. I guess you didn't need to know that last little tidbit, but I was sitting there and I'm like, 20 years experience in the same company. So if you have 20 years in the same company, you've been doing the same thing for 20 years. So if you go move on to another company, you're gonna be lost as shit. Okay? Because not every company is cookie cutter and not all of them use the same software or hardware. All right. I had a student who doesn't use any Cisco equipment at all. And they don't do access lists at all. But he wants to get a CCNA. So he needs to learn access lists. Okay. So it all depends where you work, but let's just take it as is, right? 20 years in the industry. Oh, okay. 20 years in the industry, and they know it all, or as they said, where is it? I have a pretty good idea of what I'm doing. I have a pretty good 20 years. You better have a better than a pretty good idea, okay? Everybody uses spanning tree, okay? Now, because data centers are really the driving force of this new certification, they have the spanning leaf topology, and when you're creating a spanning leaf topology, you're going to be using Ether Channel, which bypasses spanning tree. But there is a software called Trill, okay, that you can use that apparently the other little leak that's going out there, RIP and ISIS are not used anymore. Well, what do you think what happens when you run Trill? You mean what it gets enabled? Routing protocol? Oh, ISIS. How about that? Okay. So to make a generalization, you can't make a generalization like that. there's like IPv6, nobody uses IPv6. Nobody uses IPv6. Really? There's a lot of people that use IPv6. Mixed tutors. There's a whole bunch of software out there that I've seen. But there's a whole bunch of software out there that will work better than spanning tree. So you can do routing at layer two, okay? That will, become a equal cost multipath routing ECMP type network, which you'll have, you have more efficiency in the network at layer two. But again, I've always said, you got to base your device, the devices that you use, all right, all these different things in the network, all right, on your design. How big is your network? Is it one building? Is it two buildings? Is it across the United States? Or is it across the world? Okay, how is it that you're going to connect? So everything is based or designed and created and built on your network. And you want the scalability, right? And the reliability of a network, okay? But to say flat out, spanning tree, people should be executed. You're an idiot. I said it last, okay? And to say that nobody uses ISIS or RIP, you're an idiot, okay? Because it's still being taught. It's right in this book that I just showed you, ISIS. All right. Small companies may want to use static routes. Okay, that's fine. But I remember when I started at the college, the career college, They had 7 campuses. They used Static Routes. As they grew bigger, they wanted a routing protocol. Okay, there you go. All right. I don't know if they use EHRP at that moment. I didn't check. I really didn't give a shit. Okay. But because they didn't even listen for me to do VLANs. And somebody said that VLANs is an evil thing. What are you talking about? How can VLANs be an evil thing? All right. The whole purpose of VLANs is for you to segment your network. Okay. So you can reduce the amount of broadcasts, increasing the amount of broadcast domains. Do you understand that? Okay. I mean, it's the things are just ridiculous. The things that people are saying. And to say that, what is it here? No one uses NAT. First of all, nobody uses routers and nobody configures NAT on their network. It's taught throughout any networking Microsoft or Cisco class, CompTIA Network Plus, Cisco, Microsoft, everybody teaches NAT. You go buy a stinking router at Best Buy, your NAT is already running. Your ISP gives you a friggin' router. NAT is already running. Who the hell is saying that NAT is not working? Really? You have public addresses on your network? Are you running fully IPv6? No, wait a minute. You said nobody uses IPv6. What are you doing? Okay. People need to stop. They need to stop listening to guys before you use mess. Before you mess up when our man bigger building not going without VLAN, so only one VLAN, and how difficult. If you have one huge VLAN, just to answer that one question, if you have one huge VLAN, you need to look at, okay, let's say the example of the school, because these schools, these career colleges, not all of them, all right, but for a good part that I've worked, that I've experienced. See, that's the way you say it, dumbass. What I've experienced, okay, is that they, you know, the student side of it, it's all VLAN 1. The administration side of it, it's VLAN 1, but they have a separate rack. You know what that is, right? I'm not talking to the people that are in here right now. I'm talking to the moron who wrote this, what a rack is, okay? If you have one rack, let's say, you need to slowly, start putting things per department, per classroom, but slowly but surely you start taking these people off. I mean, if you work at a school, you know, midnight, you can go ahead and do that. So we can say one office is IT and tomorrow there are two. Well, again, you have to prepare. You have to prepare to scale up your network, okay? And when the way they talk about it in higher level certifications, remember the Cisco 2.0 model still exists, people. Okay. You may use a tool or tier 2, which is the distribution and core working together. All right. And then you have your access routers where all your endpoints or your end devices are at. So you need to be ready to scale up either normally on the core if it's a major enterprise or in a school. Every classroom has a switch. So why can't every classroom be a VLAN? Every department can be a VLAN. Okay, so you need to count on that. You need to, when you're designing a network, just like when you're creating a plan for anything, you need to always look forward into the future and see what may happen. You can, you know, guess the future, but you can at least say, okay, more or less I gotta do this. But VLANs are essential in a company, and you need to create them, period. And if you're a medium-sized network, you know, you're in one building and that's it, you're going to run span tree. You want redundancy, but you're going to run span tree, or you want somebody put in here, well, I forgot what it was, somebody said something about that we use span tree as well. Something is better than span tree for what's a tree or what's the catch? Well, I'm sorry. There are things out there like Trill. In the CCIE, CCMP, they talk about what's called Cisco Fabric Path. Go to Cisco. Search Cisco Fabric Path. Search ECMP. These are real world solutions that can, instead of running span tree, you can run this, okay? Which basically it boils down to routing at layer 2 with MAC addresses. So you don't have all these block ports, which then we can't really use, okay? Because even though the switch that's blocked, the port that's blocked, it still, it will put the MAC address. It's okay, I saw your MAC address, but I'm not, just not gonna put it in the MAC address table, okay? But it won't forward anything out. So that's a port that's wasted. So instead of wasting ports, you can run these real world scenarios, okay? But for the CCNA level, STP, you better learn it, what it says in the book. I don't give a shit what you do in your real world, okay? I don't care where you work. If you work for AT&T, if you work for friggin' Microsoft, if you work for, you know, Google, I don't care. You're taking a test. And if you don't pad that resume with those tests, okay, you're not going to get hired. I heard also out there in IT leaks that there's people that, hey, I just got my bachelor's degree and I got a job within 12 days. Well, either you're one lucky person, okay, or you got a relative working there, or somebody likes you, okay? Because I got plenty of students. I got over 300,000 students around the world, okay? And I got plenty of students who can blow a lot of people out of the water. I seen their resume, okay? And it's like, whoa, why aren't you working? Damn, where are you? Why aren't you here? Okay? These people, because unfortunately, employers, they don't want to hire A people. Okay? They don't want to hire A people. They want to hire people that are, they know just enough, but they still rely on you. And those are the companies you don't want to work for. You better work for them for 2 years and then get the hell out. Okay? So when you do a resume, ladies and gentlemen, okay, to get out there, you got to do it for that specific purpose, all right, for that specific job. Don't be putting everything you know out there, okay? I don't care if you got a master's, PhD, DhD, EhD, ED. No, I don't, I hope, you know, I wish anybody that. All right. Well, what? One more question. Can you a little explain what decide and how one public IP shared with multiple clients different source port? Sharing a public IP with, what do you mean? All ports have different source ports. What do you, well, you need to elaborate on that one, brother. But, because I don't get that. Because what do you mean different source port? Can you talk VLSM and FLSM? I'll be honest with you, this is the first time I hear FLSM. I'm not gonna lie there. I never heard of FLSM. Can you elaborate on that? All right, there's a whole bunch of, that's what I'm saying. Look, I'm glad that person, I can't read it, my glasses, I keep going down. That individual who put that question up right now about FLSM, there's so many different things out there, okay, that nobody knows about. Nobody knows about. And what's funny is, the higher you get in your certifications, like CCNP and CCIE, you like, what? Oh, it's that oh moment. Did you love that? Oh, okay. All right. And then you think you're a CCIE or you're a CCNP and, you know, you got your bachelor's, let's say, and you go get your certification, you're going to go and you might not even get hired. Okay. You might not even get hired. Or let's say you do get hired. Like I got hired because I went to teach Metro PCS engineers so they can get their CCNA. These guys were rock stars in what they did. These guys were the bomb. These guys were awesome. Okay. And, but they just didn't know how to take the test for the CCNA. They didn't know certain things. So I went in there, they got their CCNAs. I got hired on at Metro PCS. That's when I stopped teaching at the technical level, technical college. Well, I went from university, from colleges all the way to technical college, teach IT people. And then I went and got hired at Metro, which is now T-Mobile, and that's why I'm not there. But the telecommunications people that I got were awesome. These guys were awesome. They knew their stuff up, down, and sideways. Okay, but there's so much stuff that I saw that was brand new and using 9000 series routers, 10000 series routers. Did you know that there's commands, and depending on the iOS that you use, that you type in instead of copy, run, start, save? And if you have an issue, it's going to tell you right then and there, can't save, there's a problem with this line, and then you got to fix it and do it again. and then you save, and then it'll save. You actually save, yes or no, okay? So there's things that are not going to be in the book. They are going to be in the real world, but you got to understand the concepts, the foundation. So do you need your CCNA? Yes. Go to globed.net. I'm sure somebody put it here already on the thing. Go to globed. What's up, Greece? Go to globed.net. Check out what I'm doing. Okay. If you subscribe to the page, it's free and you can see stuff that I'm putting out there. All right. I have the 200-301. I'm working on it. Volume one is almost complete. I got some volume two stuff up there as well. All right. March 21st, I'm giving an actual boot camp on CCNA 200-301 volume one. I'm separating it. A lot of info. Okay. And then volume two, shortly after that. And in August, this bad boy right here, this bad boy, which is cool because look, CCMP and CCIE core written one test, 350-401. Okay. It's going to be in September. It's on the website. You can see it. You can go ahead and take a look at that. Okay. What's up? What's up? Well, Nat, Pat, you know, yeah. Okay. Pat is port address translation. Yeah. Source port is different source ports. That's what changes the source port. Okay. But in this certification, just so you know, and at least I would say looking at the certification previous to this, which is the 125, to the 301, I would say 60% of it is in there, okay? And the newer stuff, obviously, is like the programming, JSON, Puppet, Chef, Python, Ansible, REST APIs, okay? All that stuff, it's new. The APIC controller, Cisco DNA, very important, key topic, okay? All right, if you guys go to Amazon.com, if you like the way Cisco books are written, if you like that, then you can get the Cisco books on Amazon. I purchased this book in Amazon, okay? It's, you know, nobody else has this Cisco Press, okay? They have that. When you get your Cisco Press, if you have Cisco Press, register it on the Cisco Press site so you can go ahead and get extra information. They have flashcards, they have videos, they have things up there for you. Listen, anything in this book is fair game. Anything on their companion website is fair game to be a question. Don't think that it's not, okay? Don't think that it's not. Me personally, Todd Lamley is awesome. He's awesome. He has his volume one and volume two out there. I got this book before he got his. Also, what he got in his, I'll be quite honest with you. All right, because he's very straight to the point, very easy to learn. Listen, I'm not getting anything from Todd Lamley, okay? I just like the guy, all right? And his stuff is good, okay? His stuff is good, and it's easy to understand. It's not as granular, and doesn't need to be, as they have it in Cisco Press. Cisco Press book and Todd Lamley books are, yeah, they're not free. You got to pay for them. You got to pay. Come on. You gotta pay for them, but go to Amazon and get their stuff, okay? And get their stuff. And these guys, you know, obviously Cisco knows what they're doing, but this is not Cisco. It's the author. Like for the CCNA is Wendell Oldham. All right, for the CCNA 200-301 is Wendell Oldham. There is a disclaimer right in the very front of every Cisco Press book. If you look at it, I'm gonna open it so you guys can see it. Okay, it's right here in Roman numeral two. Okay, it's right here. It's where it says, where is it? Here, right here. Warning and disclaimer. You need to read that. Let me just read the last little line. This opinion, or the opinion expressed in this book, belongs to the author and are not necessarily those of Cisco Systems. Okay? Just so you know, every Cisco Press book has that, but everything is fair game. You can't blame Cisco. You can't blame people who are like, man, they're making this so hard. Man, they're asking me. And I'm the one that I think one of the first ones that said that. Okay? But the thing is, when you're studying, okay, like I made a funny little skit the other day on YouTube. I thought it was funny anyway. All right, about the word, oh my God, superior, I think it is what it is, they call it, superior, D-A-C-P, a rogue, a phony, a fake, a BS DHCP server, all right? They could have said that, but they didn't, right? And then I came out and I said, oh, they're trying to improve our vocabulary as well. So it's just things like that that may get you in the test. So when you're preparing for a test, prepare for all the gotchas. So not only read every last word in the book, go to the companion website, look at their videos, look at the stuff they have up there, their flashcards, practice, 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 practice. Go to, like, you listen, you don't got 4 years at a university to waste. Because in 1 year, look at that guy in LinkedIn. If you haven't looked him up, one guy got like 4 certifications in like no time. Okay. So paper wins. It'll get him in the door. He better sell himself when he goes see the IT manager. He better know his shit. Okay. So that's why you got to come to one of us. Me, when I'm doing my live online boot camps, or David's. I don't know if he does online boot camps or not, but David. You know, you got Todd does boot camps as well, I believe, online. Okay. And all these other guys, all these other top dogs, they do book. I think they do boot camps. All right. If not, they have their courses. You got to make sure that you're getting the information that you need. Okay. If you're with me on a live online boot camp and I ask a question and you stay silent, if you stay silent with me, because I think this boot camp coming up is Saturday and Sunday only, 6 hours a day, you better talk to me. You got me online. Ask me the questions at that moment, because there's not going to be 200 people in there, all right? There's going to be just a couple people. Who cares what anybody else thinks? You need to know that your answer, the answer to your question, you need to know that. And the people that are saying all this stuff that spanning tree is not being used, that static routing is 99% of the company, that nobody uses HSRP. I used HSRP in telecommunications. We troubleshooted HSRP, the VP, the administrators of the switch, all these different departments from all over the place, because there was a problem with HSRP. It took us like 3 hours, and somebody figured out the issue, and they have it, because HSRP is something that's being used. The person who says HSRP is not being used, and you're using HSRP. Thank you, Mr. Tudor, thank you. What is that? You cannot generalize. Like I said, I was doing the math. 20 years in one company, you know what you're doing for that company. Don't leave. Don't leave. Stay there. Please stay there. Okay. Or you may say, I'm going to go and work 1 year at a different company every time. Oh, really? So you think you're going to make it too far? Because once the fifth company gets you, I say, listen, man, you worked at 4 other companies. What happened? Well, no, I just quit because I wanted to go somewhere else. So you're going to quit after a year? Yeah. No. They're going to go, hey, get out of here. You know what I mean? That's not going to happen. So it's like a teacher in a public school, right? And I give props to teachers. Teachers are not really, you know, they're not giving the props that they deserve, but they do. Okay. They should. They teach math, right? You got your math teacher. Your math teacher teaches you math, whatever math it is, pre-algebra, algebra, geometry, physics, I don't freaking know, whatever they do. And that's all they do for 9 months though. The same book. For 9 months, for 20 years. The book may have evolved a little bit, taken out a chapter, put in a chapter, a little new methods. Teachers got to take their CEUs or continuing education units. They need to do that, okay? But you're teaching math, okay? That's it, okay? So I remember when I was in the career college, I taught Microsoft, I taught A+, I taught Cisco, I taught every freaking certification, Security Plus. I was like, hello? It's like doing everything. All right, so what I'm trying to say is you can get your CCNA, let's say, 2 months. Give yourself 2 months, maybe 3 max. Get your CCNA. So not only do you get certified, but you know what the hell you're doing, okay? Because if you come to me with your CCNA and I have a company, well, my company that I have, I don't have a need for IT, okay? But let's say I had a need for an IT personnel, okay? If you come to me with your CCNA and your MCSE and your Network Plus and your A+ and your Linux Plus and Security Plus and all these different certifications, I'm like, okay, you know, that gets you in the door. I'm going to talk to you. You're going to be straight with me. There is no HR here. It's me. I'm the guy. All right. And I'm going to say, hey, you know, do you like your mom? Do you and your dad have a good relationship? Would you jump out of planes? Because this is the exact questions that they asked me and tests that they gave me, psychological BS that they gave me when I would take, go to these major companies. I say, okay, you know how to do this? Cool. I'll open up a simulator. Go ahead. Configure this. I'm not going to make you do something crazy. all right? But I want to see what you know. Okay, what do you know? And I've always told people, you have experience. If you're running GNS3, if you're running Virl, if you're running EVNG, you know, an actual emulator with real iOSs, and you're configuring topologies, you have experience. Okay, but don't tell me you don't. Okay, you have. You've configured all this stuff. And those of you, all right, that have taken, that are working in ISPs and have taken CCIE labs, hands-on training, these guys know their stuff, okay? That they put you in these tremendous situations that you're like, ah, I have no idea. That's a different story. But you know what you're doing. You have experience. You need to be confident. And people like this, you know, that they're putting, because these are little things I have here from different people that they've put things out there. It's like, what, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Okay, people, I have a kid, because he said, this person said he doesn't see any automation or programmability. He has never seen it anywhere. Really? Have you been all over the world? Have you been to New Mexico? Because I have an actual instructor, his name is Luis Valle, who teaches automation for network engineers, okay, which is a course on Globe.net, all right? He's 23 years old, he has a CCMP, all right? And he is in charge of a data center's automation and programmability. How about that? Okay, so it's not, you haven't done it all. I haven't done it all, okay? Nobody has. You can't, it's an impossibility, all right? Because once you get a job somewhere, you want to climb up that corporate ladder, right? And get to as high as you can where they allow you to go. If they don't allow you to go too far, don't stay there, move. I want to give you options. See, that's the difference. These are people, these haters that couldn't get certified because, boy, well, you should see, I have a YouTube video called Alphabet Soup. Take a look at that, okay? I have people that said CCNA is bullshit, boot camps are bullshit. I said that, you know, certifications don't maintain. You need to go get your degree. You know who these people are, okay? These people are the ones that tried to get their certification and couldn't get it, or they got it and they're scared of you and they don't want you to take it. Because people, unfortunately, in today's society, people don't want you to succeed. Everybody wants you to stay down with them in the dumps. You gotta say the hell with everybody. Screw the world. Okay, Lazaro Diaz, am going to get my whatever, okay? I am going to be a CCIE. I'm going to be a Cisco architect. I'm going to be the best Python programmer in the world. I am going to do it, okay? And I don't care what nobody else tells me, all right? I want to freaking do it, okay? And if I'm lucky enough to be married to a woman who has supported me throughout my entire career and whatever I did. She said, do it. Do it again. Do this. Do that. I got your back. And she has. All right. And for 20 years, we've been married. Okay. And she's always been there for me. All right. So, but if you don't, listen, I'm here. I'm here for you. Look for me in LinkedIn. Do you know I'm having a free assessment? If you go to globed.net, I have free assessments for students to set up an appointment with me and we can talk for 45 minutes. Okay. You and me, just one-on-one. We can just talk. Okay. But, you know, this thing about people putting general statements out there, I'm very pissed. One, you need a CCNA. You need at least to go to CCMP. If you want to stay there, that's fine. Just keep renewing your CCMP. Please don't keep renewing your CCNA. Just renew the higher certification and that's it. Okay? For the CCNA, really, honestly, all you need is your packet tracer and it's free. If you go to Cisco, the Cisco NetAcad, go to get your packet tracer and you're done. Okay? What? What can you tell us about another instructor? Is it worth it? Listen, Udemy is a great platform. They're very inexpensive. Okay. So, I mean, think about it. Listen, I just went to McDonald's. Yes. I know I shouldn't. I went to McDonald's and I got me and the family some food. It cost me what? 10 bucks, 11 bucks. All right. And Udemy, you can get, you know, a certification course for 10 bucks. Okay. So for 30 bucks, you can get the same CCNA certification from three different instructors, okay? And boom. And then you mix and match and see what you like. Now, there is such a thing as too much information, okay? You've tried to do your research, you know, get the person who you identify with more because different people learn differently, Okay. Some people hate me because of the way I'm too loud. They call me a clown. There are all these different things. But you know, that's fine. Go to another instructor. There's other instructors out there that they're more for auditory learners. Okay. I'm more of a for visual learners. All right. So people can pay attention, because a person that goes to work from 9 to 5 or from 6 in the morning to 6 in the afternoon, and then has to, cause I've been there. He has to sit in a classroom, and you're going to PowerPoint him to death. And you're going to talk like this. Hello, everybody. Welcome to my class. Today we'll be covering IP addressing. And we know that IP, if you talk like, I can't even talk like that for too much, because if you talk like that, you're going to put that poor guy to sleep, or gal, or whatever. When I say guy, I mean everybody. Okay. The poor student to sleep. Okay. You can't do that. I've taught people that work night shift and they had to drive an hour to the school after doing their night shift, all right, because they're doing, going to school to better their life. And I had to teach them customer service skills. Hello. So I had to make it fun, how to make it interesting, how to make it interactive. So I like to make learning fun, all right, but obviously give the correct information, all right? If you feel that something's wrong, listen, the best way to get to me, I got LinkedIn on my phone. If you guys see my little, I don't know my picture, you can see it or not, it's the hat, me with the Panama hat on. It's black and white. I'm like tilted down a little bit, whatever. That's my LinkedIn profile. Go ahead and go down there, and then you can send me messages through there, and I'll answer it through there, okay? I currently make over 80. Okay. If the top jobs, I mean, if you're lucky to be making that kind of money, okay? Some Cisco people, even Microsoft people, it used to be back in the 2000s where Microsoft certified people were making 90 grand or better. That's not the case now. There's the industry is so flooded. It's unfortunate that some schools that were back then were just graduating. They were paper mills. They were just graduating paper MCSEs. One school in particular that doesn't exist anymore, which I'm not going to mention, but one school that doesn't exist anymore, the people were graduating with a CCNA, with a Security Plus, an X Plus, A Plus, Network Plus, MCSE. You know, they were certified from top to bottom, okay? Or bottom to top, however you want to look at it. But they didn't know what they were doing. So they were ruining the industry, because these people will actually go out there and not know anything, all right? And this is why, one of the reasons that I got into teaching was this, is because not only was, you know, I got into the industry teaching, okay? Because nobody will, every time I would try to get hired in IT, they hired their cousin. They hired somebody else. I mean, it was ridiculous. No, I want a master's, or I want a, why? Why? I got all my industry standard certifications. I remember when I worked at one of the career colleges. I mean, if you're a doctor, okay, if you're a doctor, an actual medical doctor, you got your PhD and you went through your residency and you're working at a hospital or a clinic, whatever the case may be, why in the world are you working in a career college? Is it because you want to get free education? You just like teaching? I mean, what is it? Because I remember when I was in one of the career colleges, one female, it was a female, she walked up to me and she said, "Laz, I don't understand. How can you communicate with your students if you don't have a master's degree?" At that point, I could not communicate anymore verbally. I was about to communicate physically. So I just walked away, because I don't want to go back and forth with idiots and ignorance. Okay. I ignore that completely. So if you ever hear me say, okay, I'm just going to, that means I'm just totally ignoring you and I'm not going to even ask you a question, because it just doesn't make sense. And that's not what I'm going to do on my live online bootcamp. So don't, oh man, he's not going to answer our questions. No, I am going to ask you your questions. That's why I want you to come to me live online. All right. Or if you get my courses on globed.net, if you look at it, if you go there now and you look at it, you see there are some are 12, 16, 20 minutes, but some of them are 47, 54 hour. They're long lectures. They're long lectures because I like academic freedom. I hate to be constrained. Look how much I've been talking. It's been 44 minutes. I hate to be constrained to a 20-minute lecture. Okay. And I don't like that. I don't like that at all. So Globed.net gives me the academic freedom to do whatever the hell I want. If I want to give you resources that are external, I can, because I want to. Because anybody that goes to my live online bootcamps, they get a shitload of stuff. I'm going to dump handouts and labs and all sorts of stuff on you. That's just the way I am. Okay, that's what we're gonna do. And we are gonna do labs and labs and labs and labs. Okay, CCNA, we're gonna be doing labs. All you need is a packet tracer. If you need a packet tracer, you'll be fine. Every kind of, okay. But if you wanna get higher salaries, contract jobs is where it's at. What's a good, one of the things I want to say also is, you not only do you wanna get, let's say, okay, I want my CCNA, CCNP, CCA, boom, okay. No, you want to have a little combination, just like I said, you know, high school, college, associates, bachelor's, master's, PhD. Okay, I want to get my CCNA, CCNP, designation, CCIA written, CCIA lab. You know what I'm saying? You can do that and keep renewing your CCIA written. And that's all you got to do. Okay. But you also want to have maybe a security plus that you get a DOD letter. All right. That's a good thing to have. Very good thing to have. Okay. You may want to, I mean, network plus. Okay. I mean, if you have your Cisco and you're a CCIA, network plus would be, you know, at this point, since wireless is already implemented into the CCNA, you're already very well-rounded as it is. Okay, you should be fine. All right, but getting a CompTIA certification, like let's say Security Plus, that would be a good thing. Getting, because that's a very basic security certification you can get. Linux Plus would be nice, I guess. I hate Linux. I'm not ever gonna, you know, unless I have to. Excuse me, I'll touch on Linux. But, you know, you might wanna get at least the Security Plus, at least. I'll stop there, Security Plus. All right, but you need to get something. Don't let anybody out on the internet tell you that certifications are crap, that the CCNA is an entry-level certification, because they have no idea what the hell they're talking about. Do your own research and stop listening to the naysayers. I know that's a saying that everybody says, but it's the truth, man. If I would have listened to everybody, they would have told me, you can't do this. I know how many times I've been told, you can't do that. You can't, no, it's not worth it. Don't do it. You're wasting your time. But no, I didn't listen to them. But I also have my wife slapping me in the head saying, you're going to do this. You better do it. I mean, she put the fear of God in me, and that's why I went forward. But she supports me big time, okay? But the whole point is, you have to believe in yourself. And you have to say, listen, this year, we're just starting. It's March. And look at that, January is gone. February is gone. We're in March. So you got to make this year count. In Slovakia, Central Europe, it's about 1,500 euro per month for junior. Oh, how much? 1,500 euros, that's it? That's messed up. That's messed up. But see, those are titles. Junior network engineer, engineer one, engineer two, engineer three, network architect, you know, what the hell are you talking about? I'm a senior and I have less than, that's screwed up. No, contract jobs are where the money's at, people. I'm saying this right now. Contract jobs, you make your own, yeah. I will never, ever go back into the private sector ever again. I've been doing this now, like online stuff for 5 years, I think, or longer. I don't know. I don't even know anymore. I don't even know if it's Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday. That's how crazy I am right now. Okay. But the whole point is that you got to give yourself options. CCA, you know, giving yourself all these certifications, great. You want to get your degree? I'm not saying not to. I mean, you want to be in debt for thousands of dollars, it's up to you. You know what I'm saying? But if you're going to get them, make use of them. I know people that have PhDs that work for an actual businessman that I don't know if he even has a bachelor's, but he's the one that created the business. He's the one that making the millions. So he hired the PhDs to work for him. Ain't that screwed up? They may be making, I don't know, they may be making 80,000, 90,000. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But as a contractor, I can tell you this with 100% assurance, because when I worked at a technical institution, I met a 32-year-old guy who was not CCNA certified, but did military contracts overseas. He was a civilian, did military contracts overseas, and he was in the high, not 100,000, in the high six figures. And he showed me, left my class, he was done. He got his contract to go to Virginia to do another contract job, and he was getting paid 200,000 a year, okay? To do the same thing that he's been doing. And he wasn't even certified as a CCNA yet. They made him go get a CCNA. At that time, I think it was the, I don't know if it was, I think it was the 120, the CCNA 200-120, I think. I don't think it was older than that. But Contracting is where it's at. That is where you make the tons of money. The old CCN and the new CCNP. What is it? Everyone was saying how the new CCNA was going to the old CCN and the new CCNP would be the new CCNA. Well, I have my CCN and I'm studying the new CCNA, and man, this is the best. Yeah, you gotta get your new CCNA. Forget about what everybody's saying. Okay, forget about what everybody else is saying. Get your new CCNA, because there's a lot of new terminology that has never been shown. Ways you do access, extended access list is slightly different. So there's different things that they're putting out there. How do you get started into contracting? Listen, I have no freaking clue, man. As soon as I started putting YouTube videos out and I started doing my CCNA and all these different e-learning platforms, I guess word got around. Okay, word got around and I started getting all these jobs. And then when I started doing contracting jobs, I did it for one company. I forgot who they are. And it was for the Assurant Group in Miami, and I was somewhere down south of Miami. From then on, I just kept getting more and more and more. I did a teaching contract job in Canada, Alberta University, for IPv6. Oh, look, somebody's using IPv6. How about that? In Canada, they're a bubba. All right. So people are using IPv6. So don't let nobody tell you anything different. All right. But just like anything, I don't listen to anybody. I don't follow a path, as they say. I create the path. You know that t-shirt says, lead, follow, or get out the way? I say, get out of my way. All right? Get the hell out of my way, because I'm going to run you down. Bottom friggin' line. It's just like being in the gym. Laz, don't do that. You're going to hurt your back. Laz, why are you going so heavy? You don't need to. Because I feel like it. Okay? I like it. Laz, why do you want to be as big as a tank? Because I want to be as big as a tank. I'm not as big as a tank now. I'm like a little mini tank. I'm like a Jeep, okay? But at least I want to get as big as a tank. I don't care what they say. I look at the pros. And it just changed from IT to bodybuilding, right? I look at the pros, okay? I look at the pros. And I see what they're doing. Because I want to be like them. I'm 53 years old, okay? I'm never going to be like them. But that's fine, okay? Look at this. You see this? None of you guys see this line right here? This arm is broken. I have a metal plate in this arm, and also my shoulder has 4 screws around it. I think I have like 8 or 9 screws here. All right. So, yeah, and I still go to the gym. Okay. My knee screwed up. I don't let anything stop me. You cannot let anything get in your way. All right. Period. What is the difference with it? The access list, extended access list is, you know how we normally, when we do an extended access list, we go IP, not IP. Access list 100, permit, TCP, source address, destination address, and then the destination port number. That's the normal syntax. What they're doing now for extended access list, they're using source port numbers. So when you see an extended access list that you see, you says access list 100, permit, TCP, host, whatever, 1.1.1.1, EQ80. GT greater than, less than, range, they'll put ports, source ports in there. And then your regular destination host and destination port. So there's a video, once you register your Cisco Press book online, there's a video in there. And I'm looking at this video and I asked my students that did the free assessment with me, because some of them are in IT, or a lot of them are actually, they're already in IT. They want to get their certs and, you know, what path should they follow and what have you. And I said, hey man, do you use source ports when you do extended access lists? He goes, well, we use it on rare occasions for specific applications for security purposes. Oh, okay, I understand that. But all of a sudden, boom, you just slam somebody in their head and we put a source port number on an access list for you. People that are not used to seeing that at all, they're gonna be like, what? The syntax is wrong. And they did that in the CCNA 200-125. But people didn't go to the website. People didn't go to the website. Failure is not an option. That is so correct. That is so correct. Failure is not an option. Forget those idiots that are saying you can't do it. I remember that one moron who had it. He got a CCNA, and 3 months later, he's talking crap about these instructors that are CCIEs for like 15 years that they don't know what they're talking about. And like I said, please, I want you guys to go watch my YouTube video. It's called Alphabet Soup. I'm chewing the hell out of somebody that, and this is when I was obviously younger, okay? And I was a little bit more, if you think I'm bad now, I was in everybody's face back then. So yeah, I chew this guy out. So forget about what anybody says. This is a year for you guys to change. I'm telling you, I've changed my ways. I'm doing new things. One of the things that I'm doing, and I'm preparing this. It may not be out this year. It may be out next year, but I'm going to do a course that's going to last a minimum, at least 3 months. That when you get out of that course, you will be a network engineer, because I'm going to go from zero to hero. I'm going to give you error. Because if I ask right now somebody, do you know what an MDF is? Do you know what an IDF is? Do you know how to, if I tell you right now, hey man, that phone's not working, can you see? Because people put their phones together with their PCs. They don't know how to look. They look at a rack and they're like, they don't have no idea. Okay. And that shit that people say, well, I only use layer 3 switches. Nobody uses routers. I use 9000 series switches. That's it. What are you talking about? What are you talking about? All right. Anyway, I think I've taken most of your time. It's 56 minutes. I just want to make sure that this year, make it your year. Screw the world. Get what you want. What is your goal? Go to globed.net, subscribe. It's free. It's not going to cost anything, okay? But at least you know what I'm doing, okay? Just like in my YouTube channel, The Networking Doctor. Subscribe to it. It doesn't cost anything. Now you know, well, when I come up with something, it's there. But in the globed.net, I have that free assessment. So you and me can have that 101 for 45 minutes. It's not going to cost you nothing. Let's talk, because I want you to succeed. I want you to make the money. I want you to have not only freedom, but options to do what you need to do. So forget the idiots. Forget them. Forget the morons. Oh my God, it's too hard. I can't do it. Oh, I'm traumatized. Forget those idiots, okay? Focus on you and your family and your dreams and make it happen, period. I'm here to help, all right? I thank everybody that has gone online. All right. Keep in touch. Remember, globed.net, The Networking Doctors. And if you want to reach me quick, LinkedIn profile. My LinkedIn profile, the one with a little Panama hat. Okay. But you can ask me questions. Okay. So you guys take care. Thank you so much for being here. I appreciate all of you. And remember, I'm here to help. Okay. I'm here to help. Take it easy, guys.